While the FIFA Soccer World Cup has created feverish excitement among South Africans, which is great news for national unity and team support, it hasn't been quite as inspiring for the sensible management of a monthly budget. Earlier, I spoke to Paul Slot, debt counsellor and director of Octogen, about the reality of the situation for the South African consumer, and started off by asking him to what extent World Cup mania has had an impact on spending behaviour.
The average South African spends about 6% on social spending or entertainment. Mm-hmm. And what we have seen is that that figure has almost doubled now. So that 6% extra that you're spending is coming from somewhere. The question is where.
Exactly. So let's get into it, because we're seeing this event ignite then quite a shift back towards a more discretionary spend. You know, this after having gone through a couple of years of tightening purse strings and just becoming a little bit more... letting common sense prevail, let's call it that. I mean, the problem comes now in the question, can we afford to be going down this route just yet?
I think you have to take a step backwards to say, where do we sit as South Africans? Now, if we look at our spending patterns at the moment, is that the average consumer spends about 34% on household expenditure, about 19% on financial services, pension and savings and so on, and about 47% on debt repayments. Mm-hmm. That should be closer to about 35%, 25%, and 35%. So we're spending a little bit more than what we should do on debt repayments. Against that backdrop, then we actually say, but how do we actually finance the extra spending? Mm-hmm. What we are seeing is that some people have savings.
Yeah. Because I was just going to say, I mean, with the lessons that we've learned through the economic crisis and, you know, more of a savings culture having evolved to an extent, are we not underestimating to the extent at which South African consumers saved so that they could afford to spend during this time period?
I think we're still busy repaying debt. Yeah. And because of that, we've listened and we said we have to repay a little bit more debt. But it's the question is, when do we start? Is it I'm going to start next week or after the World Cup? And how do I actually fund myself during this period? Mm-hmm. We've seen that credit card spending spending has went up by about 50%. So that's one method. We've also seen that the short-term loan industry has blossomed over this period. So people are borrowing money. Some people are borrowing money to actually spend on the World Cup, and they'll face the after party next month.
So let's take a look then at those repercussions, because, you know, we've got... is it safe to assume that we're going to be suffering an extremely bad hangover after this event passes by? Yeah.
I think some people will actually find it very difficult, and we're seeing the signs already to say, but how do I actually manage this process? Mm. And what they are doing at the moment is say, I'm going to enjoy this because it's lovely, and I'll face the consequences a little bit later. But when you have to start thinking about it to say, what is going to happen next month when I receive my pay and I have to pay a little bit more than what I should do, and what I do about the missed payments, the debt repayments that I should have paid. That's when you'll start to get phone calls from credit providers and say, you've missed a payment, what now?
So what's your advice to consumers at this stage of the game? I mean, what's the solution for those who've spent unwisely or recklessly facing looming debt problems?
I think the serious thing is to do is, like if you actually go somewhere and you don't know where you are and you're lost, you actually say, where am I? Mm-hmm. And the same applies to your personal finances as well, to say, sit down and take stock. That's probably the worst thing that people want to do, but it's something that you have to do. Take stock, where are you, and then develop a plan. And the biggest thing that people have to face is that you have to change your lifestyle for a while to actually get sorted out.
We've seen those applications for debt counselling also increasing quite significantly over the past couple of months. I mean, talk us through that process and the kind of mechanisms consumers are making use of at this stage.
There's about 170,000 consumers that have applied for debt counselling, and that process has happened. And what will happen in that process is that a specialist, a debt counsellor, will sit down, redo your budget, see how much money you have available, compare that to how much you have to repay in debt, and then work out a debt repayment plan, present it to the credit providers. If they accept it, it's confirmed in court. If not accepted, then the court will make a decision that you have to repay that. And there's some benefits from that, because first of all, that you can't spend more than, you can't create more debt because you're prohibited from doing that. But there's a plan. I think that's the big thing about it. There's a plan to say, I'm going to get out of a debt position. And what we are seeing is that people who applied for debt review 2 years or so ago, they actually starting to actually repay the debt faster. And they say, I'm getting out of trouble ahead of time.
Well, Paul, let's leave it there. Thanks so much for your time this morning.